Hello. In today's video, we're going to see about oxalate extraction. So what is extraction first? We can say extraction is the process of removing or taking out something. And oxalate extraction, it is a technique which is widely used for extracting valuable bioactive compounds from various natural sources. And sometimes this oxalate extractor is always called as a fat extractor. And this extraction process, as the name states, oxalate extraction, was found out by oxalate. So this is the picture of Franz Ritter von oxalate. He was born in 1848 and he was a German chemist, and he invented this oxalate extractor in 1879. And this oxalate has got a lot of credentials. He was the person behind this pasteurization of milk, and he was also the first scientist to fractionate the milk proteins as casein, albumin, globulin. And he also has a credential that he first described the sugar present in milk was lactose. Now let us see about oxalate extraction. So for now we have to recollect that oxalate extraction is one of the widely used methods for extracting valuable bioactive compounds from various natural sources. When we speak of natural sources, plants are very good natural sources which synthesize organic compounds, and they are referred to as very good organic synthesizers. And now let us see the process of extraction. This process, it follows the principle of similarity, in quotation, similarity. So here we use the principle of solvent reflex and siphon principle to continuously extract the solid matter by a pure solvent. So this will increase the extraction efficiency. Normally in conventional reflexing, what happens is a solvent will boil. When it is boiled or when it is heated, it will evaporate. It becomes vapor at its boiling point, and then as the vapors rise up, when it is cooled using a condenser at the top, the vapors will condense and fall down back into the flask. So that is what we call as refluxing. But in the case of oxalate extraction, apart from refluxing, we also use the siphoning out principle. So in the case of refluxing, suppose if I am taking a plant material and a solvent, the plant material and when the solvent is heated, the extractable substances from the plant material will go into the solvent. Solvent will vaporize at its boiling point, gets condensed and falls back into the plant material. But in the case of oxalate extraction, refluxing and siphoning principle takes place, so that every time new solvent will fall on the plant material, and only the solvent with the extractable will get concentrated in a separate container. See, here the concentrated solvent and the plant will be in the same container in the case of refluxing. But in the case of oxalate extraction, both will be in separate containers. So this increases the solvent efficiency. In the case of oxalate extraction, we have to take a small amount of dry sample material that is taken in a porous thimble. So this is a picture of a porous thimble. The thimble is placed in a distillation flask which contains the solvent of particular interest. And traditionally, this method, it uses a solid sample with limited solubility in the solvent in the presence of insoluble impurities. And in case a thimble is not available, we can use an ordinary filter paper for packing the substance. So I'm going to show a video where we can use an ordinary filter paper and make a indigenous thimble. In case you don't have a thimble, you can also use an ordinary filter paper, Wattmann paper, to make a thimble. So I'm just going to give a small demonstration on how to make a thimble. Instead of filter paper, I have taken an ordinary paper for demonstration purpose, but you can just take a filter paper. So you will have to take a filter paper and just roll it like this. So see that the dia is smaller than the dia of the diameter is lesser than that of the oxalate. So this dia should fit inside the column. So you just roll like this, and the lower portion of it we have to fold. So you fold the lower portion of it. And do a pressing. So now this becomes a thimble wherein you can fill the extract
and the top portion also you can similar way, just like we make a packet, you can close it. So like this you can close. This thimble you can place it inside the succinate extractor. Now we know how to make a filter paper thimble. The only caution is that the filter paper thimble, the dia should be less than that of the diameter of the succinate. This is the setup of the succinate extraction. So this video tells how we have to have the succinate extraction unit setup for the extraction process. Now we have the plant material which is to be extracted. We have to see that the plant material is finely ground so that it increases the surface area and the extraction efficiency is very high. So the plant material and ground form is taken in the thimble and the thimble is kept inside the extractor so that if it is finely ground, it will increase the surface area and the extraction efficiency is also very high. And the bottom end of the extractor is then connected to a round bottom flask which contains the solvent of interest. This is then connected to a reflex condenser. You can see it has got an inlet and an outlet for the supply for circulating the cold water. So the inlet is always through the bottom end and the outlet will be through the upper end. So water, cold water is circulated and this will ensure condensation of the solvent which is rising up at its boiling point. And when the bottom flask is heated, the solvent gets boiled up, the vapor rises through this branch pipe of the extractor. So there's a branching here. So solvent, you can see how it rises up through the extractor, then it goes up where it gets condensed because of the chill water in the condenser, which is circulated in the condenser. It falls on to the thimble, gets in contact with the substance, it extracts the material, the bioactive principle, the secondary metabolites which are present in it are extracted. And now it gets settled in this inner portion of the extractor. And when the solvent surface exceeds the highest point of the siphon, the solvent which contains the extract, it is siphoned back. You can see how it is siphoned back and falls back to the round bottom flask. So after reaching the overflow level, the solution of the thimble holder is then aspirated by the siphon, which will unload the solution back into the distillation flask. Thus, the solution which carries the extracted solute will fall into the bulk liquid and the solute will remain in the flask only, and every time only the solvent, pure solvent vapor is carried by this branching tube, and every time pure solvent only falls on the plant material. So this process is repeated till complete extraction takes place, and the pure solvent, since it falls continuously on the solvent, and the solute gets concentrated in the flask. So even though this is a rugged technique, this succinate extraction is a well established technique and it permits unattended extraction. You need not stand near it to wait for the extraction to be complete.